Ethereum is an incredibly popular platform for developing decentralized applications or DApps, but in recent years, a dramatic surge in adoption has seen the network pushed to its absolute limits, sending transaction fees through the roof and leading to rampant congestion. While some circles believe that the best way to scale Ethereum is through on-chain tweaks and upgrades, others are instead pursuing different routes, known as second-layer solutions. Though these vary significantly in their form and function, one such solution, known as Arbitrum, has begun picking up considerable momentum due to its novel solution to the problem. So, what is Arbitrum? Arbitrum is a layer 2 solution designed to improve the capabilities of Ethereum smart contracts, boosting their speed and scalability while adding in additional privacy features. The platform is designed to allow developers to easily run unmodified Ethereum virtual machine or EVM contracts and Ethereum transactions on a second layer while still benefiting from Ethereum's excellent layer 1 security. It's built to address some of the shortcomings of current Ethereum-based smart contracts, such as poor efficiency and high execution costs, which have damaged the Ethereum user experience and frequently make transacting an expensive task. Arbitrum uses a technique known as transaction rollups to record batches of submitted transactions on the Ethereum main chain and execute them on a cheap, scalable layer 2 sidechain while leveraging Ethereum to ensure correct results. This process helps to offload most of the computational and storage burdens Ethereum currently suffers from while enabling new classes of powerful layer 2 dApps. New York-based development firm Offchain Labs is currently building the Arbitrum product, as well as an entire suite of scaling solutions. The initiative is spearheaded by Offchain Labs co-founder Ed Felton, Stephen Goldfeder, and Harry Kalodiner. Ed is a professor, Stephen received his PhD, and Harry is a PhD candidate at Princeton University. All three are blockchain experts with a passion of making cryptocurrencies more capable. So, how does Arbitrum work? Well, Arbitrum is a type of technology known as an optimistic rollup. It allows Ethereum smart contracts to scale by passing messages between smart contracts on the Ethereum main chain and those on the Arbitrum second layer chain. Much of the transaction processing is completed on the second layer, and the results of this are recorded on the main chain, drastically improving speed and efficiency. It's optimistic in the sense that any validator is able to post a rollup block and confirm the validity of other blocks. While the term rollup is used to describe how public information can be used to reconstruct a complete history of the chain from an optimized log of events. The Arbitrum protocol ensures that the code will run correctly, i.e., as intended, as long as any validator is honest, helping the network resist collusion and other forms of attack. Future versions of Arbitrum will also have two other modes, channels and any trust sidechains. As with many blockchains, individual nodes can choose to participate in the Arbitrum chain. Validator nodes are involved in observing the state of the chain, and full nodes help to aggregate layer 1 transactions. Aggregators that submit transactions to the layer 1 chain earn rewards paid in ETH, while the rest of the user transaction fees are distributed to other network participants, such as validators. Arbitrum introduces a challenging step for rollup blocks, which sees other validators check the correctness of a block and issue a challenge if they believe it is wrong. If the block is proven to be wrong or a challenge is proven to be unjustified, the line validator will have their stake confiscated, ensuring validators always play fair or risk the consequences. The platform also has its own custom virtual machine, aptly named the Arbitrum Virtual Machine or AVM. This is the execution environment for Arbitrum smart contracts and exists above the ETH bridge, which is the set of smart contracts that interfaces with the Arbitrum chain. Ethereum compatible smart contracts are automatically translated to run on the AVM. So, what makes Arbitrum unique? The project is designed to provide an easy-to-use platform developers can use to launch highly efficient and scalable Ethereum-compatible smart contracts. But it's not the first platform looking to overcome Ethereum's limitations, and there are at least a dozen other solutions looking to offer similar functionality. So what separates Arbitrum from the rest? Well, it has several distinguishing features, including high EVM compatibility. So Arbitrum is considered to be one of the most EVM-compatible rollups. It's compatible with the EVM at the bytecode level, and any language that can compile to EVM works out of the box, such as Solidity and Viper. And this makes it easy to develop on, since developers do not need to get to grips with a new language before building on Arbitrum. Also, it has robust developer tooling, so the team behind Arbitrum are doing what they can to minimize barriers to entry when it comes to building on their layer 2 solution. As such, they've produced comprehensive developer documentation for Arbitrum, and the developers can get started using existing tooling for Ethereum. There's no need to download anything specific specific to Arbitrum, such as plugins or compilers like Hardhat or Truffle. Then there's also low fees. So as a layer 2 scaling solution for Ethereum, Arbitrum isn't just designed to boost Ethereum's transactional throughput, it is also designed to minimize transaction fees at the same time. Thanks to its extremely efficient rollup technology, Arbitrum is able to cut fees down to just a tiny fraction of what they are on Ethereum, while still providing sufficient incentives for validators. So next up, let's talk about the top protocols on Arbitrum ranked by total value locked. First of all, we have GMX. Known for its unique dual token model using GLP, a basket of stablecoins, and blue chip assets, and of course the GMX token, GMX is a spot and perpetual decentralized exchange or DEX. Originating from Binance Smart Chain as Gambit, GMX expanded to Avalanche as GMX, and eventually to Arbitrum in August of 2022. Due to its high yields on GLP during the bear market, GMX gained popularity alongside the real yield narrative, quickly taking the top position in Arbitrum and dominating the position since. In fact, GMX is the fourth highest revenue generating project across all blockchains and decentralized applications in DApps in the last 180 days. And for the second spot, we have Uniswap V3. As one of the first AMMs to gain significant traction in DeFi, Uniswap is a household name in the space, with more than $4 billion in TVL across 5 chains. Uniswap also popularized the concentrated liquidity model with Uniswap V3, which greatly increased the capital efficiency of the protocol and has since been duplicated on several other DEXs. Today, Uniswap holds more than $150 million on Arbitrum alone. And then coming in for the third spot, we have Radiant Capital. Radiant Capital is currently the top money market protocol of Arbitrum, and Radiant facilitates lending and borrowing on-chain, but with a twist. It aims to be an omni-chain money market platform. This means that their goal is for users to be able to deposit assets on one chain and borrow against their collateral on another chain. Radiant Capital partnered with Stargate to facilitate their omni-chain vision. Coming in for the fourth spot, we have Sushi. Hot on its heels, fellow multi-chain AMM and Uniswap fork, Sushi is fourth in the Arbitrum ecosystem. Sushi has long pursued a more aggressive expansion across chains compared to Uniswap and has operations on almost 20 chains with more than $600 million in TVL. Although Sushi launched on Arbitrum 3 months before Uniswap in May of 2021, they eventually lost their first mover edge to their close rival. And then coming in for the fifth position, we have Zyberswap. Zyberswap is a traditional automated market maker, or AMM, with liquidity pools for users to deposit into and earn yield on. Zyberswap currently supports extremely high yields on native token pairs using native token emissions, and the high yields on these pools have successfully bootstrapped a significant pool of liquidity for Zyberswap, quickly sending them into the top 10 highest TVL protocols on Arbitrum in just a short span of 3 weeks against strong competitors such as Uniswap and Sushi. Coming in for the sixth position, we have Synapse Protocol. Originally launched as a stable swap protocol, Nerve, on the Binance Smart Chain, they later rebranded to Synapse as a bridging protocol, bridging stablecoins across various supported chains. Today, Synapse services 17 different chains, with Arbitrum holding the largest portion of its TVL at $88 million. Synapse has also increased their list of supported assets to include ETH and tokens of established projects such as GMX, Olympus DAO, and Vesta Finance, among many others. Synapse has also hinted at plans for their very own chain, Synapse Chain, in the future, with single-sided staking for the SYN token to become possible with such an implementation. And then coming in for the seventh position, we have Camelot DEX. Camelot DEX is an Arbitrum-native DEX with an AMM as its main product and multiple complementary offerings to support the protocol. Some of the innovative features that Camelot has implemented currently include dual liquidity types, which support volatile swaps and stable swaps, and dynamic trading fees, which allow each pool to have their own trading fee and variable trading fees based on the direction of the trade. On top of that, Camelot also represents staked liquidity pool positions using NFTs, also known as SPNFTs. SPNFTs continue to earn yield and fees as with traditional liquidity provision. However, they can also be locked to boost yield on their positions, and certain pools also require locked positions to be utilized for additional yield. And then for the eighth spot, we have Curve Finance. So Curve Finance is an AMM designed to provide low slippage swaps between assets with identical pegs, such as stablecoins or ETH liquid staking derivatives, or LSDs. Since its launch, Curve has become the de facto DEX for stablecoin swaps across more than 10 chains and solidified its position as a DeFi titan. Curve is also known for its vote escrowed CRV tokens, where CRV token holders can lock their tokens for up to 4 years in exchange for voting power, rewards, and bribes DApps from external protocols. This tokenomics model continues to be copied across new projects, highlighting its continued success many years after their launch. Curve continues to innovate and is expected to ship out their native stablecoin CRV USD sometime in early 2023. And then for the ninth position, we have Aave. Anyone who has engaged in lending or borrowing activities on chain before would have definitely have heard of the name Aave. Beginning as ETHLEND in 2017, Aave rose to prominence as DeFi's dominant money market protocol, quickly climbing to become the fourth largest dApp by TVL. Coming in for the final position, we have Solid Lizard. Modeled after the famous Solidly project on the Phantom blockchain, Solid Lizard brings the V33 model to Arbitrum. The V33 model combines the Votescrowed V token model from Curve Finance and the 33 rebasing model from Olympus DAO. And the result? A unique system of governance and liquidity incentivization. So that's a little bit about Arbitrum. Let us know your thoughts on the project down below.